Hey guys, my name is Frank Dorof and welcome in our studio in Emmeloord in the Netherlands. Now if you followed my social media recently, you know that we switched throw brands. We went from Ellingrom to Hensel. And Hensel is a really good German brand, it's really high-end and they have some amazing strobes but also some amazing modifiers. Now this series is all about my favorite modifiers and lighting tips with those modifiers. Now, if you don't shoot Hensel, don't worry, don't stop the video for the very simple reason all the tips I'm going to give you, all the modifiers I'm going to talk about, you can also use with your own modifiers or brands. For example, a beauty dish, in essence, is a beauty dish. The lighting tips I'm going to give you, you can also do with your own beauty dish. But if you really think like, hey, those Hensel modifiers look really cool, and they do, you can also get a modifier converter. Now, what is a modifier converter? It's actually a sort of adapter ring that you put on your strobe brand, and then you can mount other modifiers, for example, from Hensel or Profoto or Ellingrom or whatever. And those can be really cheap. Now, if you go to your local camera store, they also have some of those modifiers, but they probably will be a little bit more expensive or they don't have the brand that you need. My advice, and in this case, just do it, go to those sites like Alibaba or AliExpress and just order them online. They're really cheap and sometimes the quality can be a little bit flaky, but hey, you can always try it out, right? Okay, today, my favorite modifier, and I think the modifier that you guys really should have in your studio, the beauty dish. So what is a beauty dish? Well, it's actually a beauty light. You know, it's the name, right? But in essence, it's absolutely right. So what does a beauty dish do? Well, it's a big dish and you have a small deflector right in front of your front strobe. So that means that the light will actually hit that deflector, goes back into the dish and then actually spreads out. And you get this beautiful, crispy, nice quality of light. Now, there are many different kinds of beauty dishes. You have smaller ones and you have bigger ones and something in the middle. My personal opinion is I wouldn't go for the bigger ones. If you go for the bigger one, I actually prefer soft boxes or octa boxes or whatever, you know what I mean, right? But a big beauty dish, my personal opinion, there are better alternatives. Now, if you go to the slightly smaller beauty dishes, those are absolutely awesome. They give you a really crispy light quality. Now you have beauty dishes that are white and silver. Now my personal, and this is again personal flavor, is silver because I like that really nice edge in my lighting. Now of course a beauty dish spreads out the light beautifully and you get this beautiful, beautiful look on your model. That's why it's called a beauty dish. But you can also modify your beauty dish. Now for almost every brand, you can get grids in front. Now, the grid will actually narrow that light beam and makes it more, let's say, focused on your model. So you really have the light on your model and everything besides is actually cut off because, again, it really narrows that light beam. Now, the cool thing about the Hensel beauty dish is actually that you can place the grid in front. So you have the deflector, you have the dish, and then you can put a grid in front. But you can also opt to not put the deflector in and put a little bit of a grid inside the beauty dish. And of course you can make combinations like a grid inside and a grid in front to really get a narrow beam of light, or the deflector with the grid or only the grid. And in my opinion, it's really cool to have a modifier that gives you so many different options because, well, you can only spend your money once. And if you buy a modifier that can that's a one-trick pony, you spend all your money on that one-trick pony. So why not just get a modifier that's very versatile? And another thing that you can do with the beauty dish is actually you can also mount gels inside the beauty dish. So it's very, very versatile. And this is, by the way, one of the reasons I really like the beauty dish from Hensel. Now, I already made a video about this beauty dish. I will leave the link below so you guys can actually check that one out too. But let's go to our studio. And let's just do some shots with the beauty dish with different configurations and you can see the results and what those configurations do. It's gonna be fun. So join us to the studio. Day.
rained without water along the sun-soaked road. We crossed over borders to get where we are, and it's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. I did it all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. It's all for you. Nights without sleeping, 'cause you fear the night. And days without eating, 'cause it ain't enough for two. And it's all for you. 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 It's all for you.
Okay, isn't that beauty, this incredibly flexible? Now, my favorite setups, there are actually three. Now, of course, I like the beauty disc as it's designed for the very simple reason it gives you a beautiful, nice, crispy beauty light. I also like it with the, well, the grid in front, because you can really narrow down that light. Now, you saw me using it once with only a grid in the middle and the beauty disc bare. That's the one that I didn't really like. It's a little bit in between. It's nice and harsh, but it has too much light spill off. The one that I really fell in love with, and that was the first time I used it because we just got this Hensel gear in, is actually the one with the grid in the middle and the grid in front. And I never ever used a beauty disc before that had that option. So I was very excited to try that out, and I fell in love with it. It's such a beautiful light quality. Now, of course, light quality is always incredibly personal. Some people like a really soft quality of light. Some people like it more harsh. I'm a little bit in the middle. And I think that real crispiness really showed up. Hey guys, if you like what we do, subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course, smash that like button because we really like that. And if you have any questions or you want me to try out stuff, leave it in the comments below. These videos are about one modifier. Of course, in our normal photo shoots, we use different modifiers combined, unless, of course, we use one strobe. But most of the time, we use more strobes. So I hope you enjoyed this and see you again next time. And then it will be about another modifier.